All right. Hello, everyone. My name is Master Starman, and welcome to... welcome to a direct reaction, which I am recording later than I anticipated, but that's okay. That's okay. It's just gonna be me by myself today. I was out for most of the day, so I have to watch this one by myself. So, oh well. That's gonna be fine. Let's just see how this goes here. See what this entails. Just gonna hope the audio balance is fine here. I don't really have any super specific expectations. Oh, Scarlet and Violet news to start off, I guess. I don't know, like, what's good audio balance here, so I'm just trying to make sure things aren't too overbearing, you know? I have yet to actually play Scarlet and Violet, so I don't know what to really expect of this here. I know the DLC was announced for this a while ago, but yeah. At some point, I'll probably pick these games up. I generally do like Pokemon games. I've just kind of been a little burnt out of the series for the last couple of years, and I just didn't feel like I needed to move on quite when the series was ready to move on, I guess. But... yeah... I know they did have a trailer for this before, I just don't know, like, what's different with this. Yeah, I think this thing was shown off before, I think. Yeah, I don't really have too many expectations for the Direct in general. I mean, this was a pretty safe bet to kind of think about, but... yeah, 40 minutes of this Direct is definitely a lot, though. The cynical part is, like, please be this time for Mario Party, but, like, at this point it's been, what, like, 4 Directs since that came out, and there hasn't been any update on that, so it's probably not gonna happen, but there is the part of me inside that wants them to do that, so... I'm guessing some of these are... mons that haven't been shown in the game yet. Like, I don't know what's in Scarlet and Violet already. I just know, like, yeah. All right.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be one of your guides for today's Nintendo Direct.
I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll
also... alright, let's see what we got today.
That was the latest trailer for the hidden treasure of Area Zero, the paid DLC for the Pokemon Scarlet and Pokemon Violet games. The first half of the trailer took place at a festival in the countryside,
while the second half seemed to be in a completely different location, a futuristic academy in the middle of the ocean. More details on this DLC will be available in the future.
All right.
And after today's Nintendo Direct, a special event will be held in Pokemon Scarlet and Pokemon Violet. We hope you'll participate in it.
All right.
Okay, let's see our first batch of headlines.
What do we got? It's a super Sonic. Wrong superstars!
Sonic Sonic and friends are spin dashing into a brand new 2D side-scrolling game, Sonic Superstars. 12 brand new zones await. Speed through beautiful worlds as Sonic.
Is that 12 zones? I had a very, very cynical reaction to this trailer when it happened the other day, because I don't know, is it bad that this trailer just gave me Sonic 4 vibes when I first saw it? And also, I heard this game was going to be a full-price game, which I don't know, I'm not one to get, like, upset at the whole, like, oh, games, 2D games aren't worth $60. I don't believe that, but I just didn't think this was going to be, and yeah, it's also a local co-op only game, too, like, I don't know, I guess my reaction was when Sonic Mania was, like, a fraction of this game's price, like, I don't know, something about it just seemed,
A cozy life is just around the corner. Welcome to Palia. In this free-to-play adventure sim, create the idyllic life of your dreams.
Is this announced already? I could technically be, like, skipping through this if I want. I'm not, I probably won't do that just because I do like watching the directs as if I was watching live, but
grow crops in your garden and more.
Yeah.
Play with other residents in online co-op or carve out your blissful life solo. And if you're eager to explore,
was this shown off in that direct of, like, nothing but farm sims?
Set off on a vast journey to uncover Palia's many mysteries. Or just kick back and relax.
Maybe not. I don't know.
How you live is entirely up to you. What kind of coziness will you choose? Palia is free to play and launches on Nintendo Switch this holiday.
Okay.
Ignite your heart.
Okay, let's go. This was announced a few days ago already, but I'm always down for some Persona.
Spin-off of Persona 5. When the group ends up in an unfamiliar world, they must join forces with a revolutionary named Arena to combat the armies that
I've played through Persona 5 Royal and Persona 5 Strikers in the last year now, and Persona 3 Portable as well, so
from afar, or using a Persona.
Not, like, super big on tactics games sometimes, but I'd be down to play this.
Take them out with dramatic flair using the new all-out attack.
Oh yeah.
The fusion ability from the Persona series returns, allowing you to combine personas to form other ones. What is Arena's true objective?
A tactics game with Persona stuff does seem like a pretty good idea.
A revolutionary tale will ignite when Persona 5 Tactica launches on Nintendo Switch November 17th. Pre-orders for the physical version of the game begin today.
I'll probably check that out.
Local retailers.
I do like me some Persona 5.
Step into a Saturday morning cartoon. Calling all first-person roguelike adventure, MythForce. Enter a high fantasy world inspired by Saturday morning cartoons of the past. It's up to you to stop the evil Daedalus from taking over.
Okay, so, like, stuff like He-Man and I was always really confused by the term Saturday morning cartoon, because, like, a lot of people associate that as, like, it, like, 80s, like, He-Man, like, Ninja Turtles. I don't want to say, like, the toy shows, but that's kind of, like, I think what notion those generally get labeled as. Yeah, they were clearly just going for a He-Man reference there.
This year. This Blackfest is going to be pretty sweet.
Okay, game I don't play, but I'm curious what this Splatfest is.
Splatoon 3 game has been confirmed. Okay, squids, here's the theme.
Let's see it.
Which flavor of ice cream is best? Vanilla, strawberry, or mint chip?
Why is chocolate not in this? During the dates shown on screen. Yeah, almost had Neapolitan colors, but clearly didn't want that, I guess.
These choices are delicious. Guide your favorite flavor to victory. Plus, get splatting in themed battles.
More splat-tastic events are on the way. I'm kind of basic with my ice cream, and I generally like vanilla. Pokemon again?
To promote an even stronger bond between the people and Pokemon of Rhyme City.
Oh, is this, Detective Pikachu? Okay, I know some people are probably exciting.
Disguises are a key part of detective work.
Now people can finally zip it. And I've heard people say this was in development for a number of years, so.
A light roast today, huh?
Because, yeah, the first Detective Pikachu was like 2018, I think. So. What was that Ludicolo voice?
Something the two of you must know.
You too. Based on our deductions, the culprit is clear, isn't it?
A bolt of brilliance.
The name's Pikachu. And I'm what you might call a great detective.
Alright.
I sure wish somebody would bring me some coffee.
That was Detective Pikachu Returns.
Looks like he still loves coffee.
What cases will Tim and this tough-talking Pikachu solve together? More info will be revealed in the future.
I just remember the Scarlet Violet trailer, like, starting off looking like it was going to be a Detective Pikachu trailer, but... Mario RPG? Is this coming to the NSO, or is it... People have rumored... Really? They're remaking Super Mario RPG? You know what? I won't complain about that. Wow, this actually looks really good. Oh, Mallow. Wow, they're remaking Super Mario RPG. I'd be down to play this. I've been wanting to replay Mario RPG for... Oh, God. Probably a little while. Like... I last played this when I Let's Played this, and that was a full decade ago now, just to throw the gray hairs on me there. This is actually a really cool trailer. I'd be down to play this again. All right. That's been the highlight of this.
Super Mario RPG returns with brand new graphics.
Whether you played the original game,
I'm definitely interested in this.
To jump into the very first RPG in the Mario series.
Mr. Koizumi, that last trailer featured Mario, but he's not the only one getting a game.
Huh? What do you mean?
Hmm?
Let's take a peek.
Princess Peach will star as the main character in a brand new game.
When she steps on this particular spot on stage.
Huh? Whoa. What on earth is happening?
I agree. What on earth is
That's
happening?
All we'll show for now. We'll share more details at a later date. Mr. Koizumi.
All right.
There's actually something else.
What?
Hmm?
Visually enhanced version of Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon, originally released on Nintendo 3DS, is in development.
We hope you look forward to seeing more.
Okay, I've never played Dark Moon, but I really liked Luigi's Mansion 3, so okay.
Will launch next year.
Okay.
Mario, Princess Peach, and Luigi. Looks like Mario fans have a lot of games to look forward to.
More details will be shared in the future.
All right.
Alright, let's see some more headlines.
Mario RPG is definitely the highlight there.
Become Gotham City's ultimate protector.
Arkham series collection?
Wake up, Mr. Wayne.
Arkham Asylum City and Origins?
I want you to know the fear that is coming. This is the beginning of the end for you, Dark.
Oh, there's four games in this, isn't there?
You still know how to make an entrance.
Welcome to the madhouse, Batman.
Today is the Joker's big homecoming, and you're the guest of honor.
Arkham City, there we go. I want to give this game another shot sometime. Oh, and Arkham Knight. What about Arkham Origins then? Yeah, what about Arkham Origins?
Would be ours.
Over my dead body.
I want to give Arkham, at least Arkham City, another chance, because, like, I own that, but I didn't really get a chance to play it too much.
Don't be a stranger. You're always welcome here.
Yeah, no, these are, like, I remember when Arkham City was kind of highlighted as kind of like one of the biggest, like, games of that year. And it scares me how long ago that was.
Lead your mercenaries through cursed dungeons in the lands of Gloomhaven. Your tactical prowess is all that stands between riches and certain death. This adaptation of the hit board game features turn-based card battles with RPG elements. Unleash deadly combos and bring doom upon your foes. But beware, exhaustion is close in.
This is just sleeper hit here. Not even hit, just sleeper.
And master over 1,000 abilities. Hone your deck, set up synergies, and gain every advantage to survive. Grit your teeth and earn your keep when Gloomhaven launches on the Nintendo Switch system September 18th. Pre-orders for the Mercenaries and Gold Editions begin today on Nintendo eShop.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Keep the dance party going.
Gotta mute here. Yep, muting this here. See, we're just over halfway into the direct here, but so instead, here's, can this, like, trailer end here soon? Because we just, yeah, no. Like, can we just, get, like, I don't know, like, what can I play here and, like, I don't know, I screwed that up pretty badly, but let's just, like, I don't know, man. We don't need Just Dance in a direct here.
Eyes in a world without words.
Alright.
One day, a once peaceful realm was silenced by its king. Now,
7 wordless warriors will rise. In this action RPG, these heroes bound by fate must work together to explore the abyss and find the secluded king. However, with its ever-changing dungeons and powerful foes, conquering the abyss will be no easy feat. Wield weapons like swords, bows, magic, and more to survive
okay.
this deadly chasm. After you return to base, materials you've collected will help you cultivate resources and forge new items. Repeated forays into the abyss will enable you to grow stronger and dive deeper.
Wait, is this a Story of Seasons game, or am I imagining things?
Your guide on this journey is the kingdom's sorrowful princess, encased in a crystal.
No, it said it wasn't earlier. The cow looked very Harvest Moon for a second.
In the hearts of the silent warriors. Why did the king steal the world's words? And what awaits the warriors in the depths of the abyss? Silent Hope dives onto Nintendo.
Oh, it is. Okay, Exceed and Marvelous. That would explain why that cow looked familiar.
Sparks will fly in these Nintendo Switch games.
Mario and Rabbids?
Cast spells and cultivate your best life in Fae Farm.
Oh boy, Farm Sim.
Make use of magic to complete tasks and fend off mischievous foes. Enrich your farm to help your character flourish. Decorate your space to improve your stats for the day ahead. And enchant your friends locally or online in 4-player co-op. Fae Farm launches as a console exclusive on Nintendo Switch September 8th. Pre-orders, including an in-game bonus, are available now on Nintendo eShop. Zoom into wild racing
Hot Wheels.
With Hot Wheels Unleashed 2 Turbocharged. Choose from over 130 vehicles.
I forget, was the original of this, like, any good, or was it kind of a weird, like, glitch fest? I thought I remember people talking about this game when it came out, but, like, I don't remember.
Friends in split-screen co-op. Plus, up to 12 players can hit the track online. Grab the wheel when this game speeds onto the Nintendo Switch system October 19th. Get your chassis looking classy in Manic Mechanics.
Okay, is this like Overcooked but with cars?
Repair vehicles quickly to earn points in solo play or 4-player co-op.
Oh boy, this it's just oh god. This just looks like Overcooked but with cars and
launches first for consoles on Nintendo Switch July 13th.
Okay.
Begin today on Nintendo eShop. Introducing the second
Here's Sparks of Hope.
For Mario plus Rabbids, Sparks
I need to play this at some point.
Mario and friends journey to a musical planet filled with new areas to explore.
I started playing this game, but at the same time, I also never finished Kingdom Battle, so I think they had a trailer for this the other day. I didn't watch it yet, though. Okay, later today.
A demo of the main game is available now on Nintendo eShop.
Okay. I have that and, like, Kingdom Battle, but Dragon Quest of some kind?
You intend to take arms against me?
Very well.
You are now cursed, unable to harm monsters.
What? What the?
You're going to have to become a monster wrangler.
Don't take my copyright here. Dragon Quest Monsters, I assume. I've never played these games, but I've heard they do kind of have a bit of a cult following. I'm sure the VOD would be fine with this anyway, because usually, I mean, it was fine when, like, they did the, yeah, Dragon Quest Monsters. Square Enix is doing pretty good this direct, I've noticed. Oh, the Dragon Quest IV hero.
Hey, I know that guy from a little-known crossover game called Super Smash Brothers.
What kind of journey will you take to become the master of monster kind? Please be on the lookout for more info in the future.
Next, we have more news on a certain game with plant-like creatures.
Is this... Oh, Pikmin. Okay, that makes more sense. When I first said plant, I was like, is this Plants vs. Zombies? But no, Pikmin 4 makes a lot more sense. This should be a good time. I do generally like the Pikmin series.
And the adorable rescue pup, Ochi. Good boy.
Ochi.
Your mission, should you choose to accept it, repair the damaged rescue core spaceship and save any castaways you find. All right, let's explore together.
Okay.
Once plucked, Pikmin are ready for
action. I'm curious how well I'm gonna adjust to the new camera system, because just when I think of Pikmin, I always think over the, like, overhead. I'm curious how this is gonna work with... Okay, yeah, see, this is, that was kind of more the angle I was hoping it would be, like, a little bit more overhead.
And if you need a flotation device, well, there you go. Ochi can even stand up to the wildest creatures. Collect lots of treasures scattered around the planet to fix the spaceship's radar and open up new areas to explore.
Sorry, the Game Boy Advance SP kind of caught me off guard. Also, that was a cannon beetle.
Why not take the plunge underground?
Caves!
Here, a completely different environment awaits.
Jeez, what are these?
Unusual contraptions. Native creatures.
Oh boy. Jesus, that is a big Wallywog.
More treasures are around every corner. You might unexpectedly find some castaways, too.
Okay.
Hey, wait a minute. This leafy individual just nabbed the castaway. You've got to stop him. It's time for a Dandori battle. Embrace the art of Dandori by strategically issuing commands to your Pikmin and Ochi. Collect more objects than your opponent within the time limit to win, and
oh,
save the castaway.
That's different.
By rescuing castaways, you'll be able to do more activities back at base camp, which is right next to your spaceship.
Okay.
Train Ochi and teach him new skills. Or build new equipment and items to help make exploration more manageable. For the first
okay.
time in the Pikmin series, you can eventually set out for night expeditions.
Oh god.
There's a catch.
Yeah, everything's gonna be rough at night.
So stay alert.
Oh no.
Thankfully, you'll come across the new Glow Pikmin, which
oh.
only appear at night. Find luminols.
That just Chugga Conroy's old logo circa his Pikmin 2 Luigi's Mansion LP.
So use Glow Pikmin to drive them away and protect the luminols. Many more surprises await on this.
Oh, I didn't quite catch that what the glow's abilities were, but that's kind of neat.
Ochi by your side, no challenge is too big or too small.
Okay, so we have wings and rocks back as well.
Pikmin 4.
All right.
In past Pikmin games, you had to return to your spaceship before sundown. However, in this latest entry, you can now venture out at night. We hope you can lead the Pikmin on your expedition.
Okay.
We have even more Pikmin news to share.
Oh? Pikmin 1 and 2 on Switch?
The first two Pikmin games,
yep! Let's go!
Nintendo GameCube will launch on Nintendo eShop later today.
Okay!
Ahead of the game's release, a demo of Pikmin 4 will be available on
Nintendo okay.
on June 28th.
Huh.
The demo can be enjoyed even if you've
not. I hope they're bundled together and not separately. I mean, I'll still probably get them anyway, but I'll probably hold off on the physicals of those just because I'm not itching the most to play Pikmin 2, but. And I just played Pikmin 1, like, not too long ago. Metal Gear. Okay.
Metal Gear Solid Master Collection Volume 1.
Okay.
This compilation includes Metal Gear Solid. Infiltrate and regain control of Shadow Moses Island.
That's pretty exciting. Solid 2, Sons of Liberty. I know these games are, have like a super huge reputation, but I'm gonna be perfectly honest. I've never actually played Metal Gear Solid. I played the demo of the 3DS version of this game. So.
Also enjoy the games that started the series.
Okay.
Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake, as well as the NES versions of both.
Okay.
Metal Gear and Snake's Revenge. This compilation also contains the first Metal Gear Solid digital graphic novel and its sequel.
All right, that does have me interested. I'm curious. I'll be curious to check this out.
With story and character info, strategy guides for each game, and a digital soundtrack. Metal Gear Solid.
As someone who's never played these games, I think that would be.
Launches on Nintendo Switch, October 24th.
All right.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. The first three Metal Gear Solid games will also be available separately on Nintendo eShop.
Okay.
It's time to survive.
Dead Cells Castlevania? Or is. Oh.
Vampire Survivors.
Oh.
Is coming to Nintendo Switch.
Okay, this wasn't what I thought it was.
What it takes to survive a 30-minute onslaught of monsters.
I've heard a lot of people talk about this game. I don't really know too much about what it is, but.
With your weapons. Seems easy at first, right? But swarms of increasingly stronger monsters will appear the longer you survive. By getting treasure chests from defeated enemies, or by leveling up, you'll acquire weapons and upgrades for your character, so shape them as you see fit. Plus, up to 4 players can now play together in couch co-op. What other horrors lie in store? Find out when Vampire Survivors launches on the Nintendo Switch system, August 17th.
Okay.
Music and pigeons? Sounds pretty cool.
I hope this isn't licensed music, but it's.
Play online in this rhythm battle royale and aim to be the last bird standing.
I'm sorry, what?
30 players can ruffle each other's feathers in musical minigames.
I hope this music's not copywritten, but.
Yes, Commander.
This actually.
Piano shooter. Race and fly to the rhythm in, to the sky, and more.
It kind of just looks all sorts of crazy and ridiculous.
Get ready to shake those pigeon tails when Headbangers Rhythm Royale bops its way onto Nintendo Switch October 31st. Ready, set, yo! Penny is on the run. Entangled in a chaotic audition that veered way off script, she's managed to make some powerful enemies and a newly animated friend. In this 3D platforming adventure from the team behind Sonic Mania, you'll explore the colorful world of Macaroon and help Penny and escape the clutches of the grouchy Emperor Eddie.
So this must mean, like, what? Was it Christian Whitehead, I think, who made Sonic Mania, or in, like, his team? Don't say something that makes me think of Mario Party Man.
You can also put your speedrunning skills to the test in Time Attack mode.
That seems pretty neat.
Special items, complete secret stages, and more. This is your big break, after all. Take the stage when Penny's big breakaway.
I should mention, I guess, now whenever I don't know when this will be, but whenever I let's play Pikmin 2, it will be with this Switch version. Alright, what do we got?
A brand new course is racing into Wave 5 of the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Booster Course Pass DLC. Introducing Squeaky Clean Sprint.
That is definitely a Petey Piranha!
Mario Kart Double Dash.
Petey Piranha. Wow, it's been a while since we've seen him. And Wiggler. Okay.
And from Mario Kart Tour, Kamek.
Okay.
Wave 5 of the Mario Kart
8. All right, no Rob, but the fact I have characters from more from Double Dash and
zooms onto Nintendo Switch.
Okay.
Active Nintendo Switch Online.
Still no Diddy or Funky or like any Kong for that matter. That's
the DLC can also be purchased on its own.
Okay.
Two worlds, one full encounter. A remake of the second Star Ocean game, complete with new graphics that fuse 2D and 3D, is on the way.
Okay.
After a mission goes wrong, Federation Officer Claude is stranded on an undeveloped planet. There, he meets Reyna, who possesses mystical powers. Was it fate or mere coincidence? Soon after, the two get entangled in a sinister plot within the galaxy. In this science fantasy RPG, select either Claude or Reyna as your hero and play through the story from their perspective. You'll also meet over a dozen potential allies from all walks of life. During your adventure, the hero you chose and the decisions you make will have an impact on who can be recruited to your cause.
The enemy, is it?
Battles take place in real time. And skills can be performed with a single button.
Okay.
New combat features in this remake include stunning enemies with chain attacks. And having allies not in your current party unleash follow-up attacks, letting you map out strategic battles.
That's like fighting game mechanics in like an RPG. That's kind of neat.
An ancient prophecy will unfold, and your destiny will be awakened. Save the planet in Star Ocean, the second story arc, launching on Nintendo Switch.
That seemed pretty neat.
It's time to move it, Wario style.
New WarioWare?
Get ready for more micro game mayhem in the latest WarioWare game.
Hold two. Is this DLC for Get It Together?
Move your body to take on a flurry of lightning fast micro games.
What you or is it
and how you move depends on the micro game. React quickly with the right.
I'm kinda surprised they would release a game like this. Mario 64 DS, that was kind of an odd thing to see. I was about to say it's kind of odd to see a game like this now that's like heavily Joy-Con focused, because
board game is gonna keep you on your toes.
I would think, like, especially with how many people own like Switch Lights at this point, like
over 200 lightning.
Oh, okay, Pikmin.
In WarioWare, move it. Launching on the Nintendo Switch system.
Okay, so it's only been like 2 years since the last WarioWare, so
why aren't you saying anything? Was so into it, I didn't want to interrupt. Anyway, this is the latest WarioWare game. You'll use your entire body.
I'm surprised it hasn't been that long since the last WarioWare. Again, the Mario 64 DS assets are really wild to me.
Families can join the fun at Nintendo Live 2023. Play games, enjoy live performances, take photos with some of your favorite characters. And more.
I'd want to know what the idea behind this is, like, outside the tournaments, like,
also compete in on-site tournaments and participate in a last chance qualifier.
Like,
this all ages celebration is free and will take place.
I don't know, like, to me the idea that going to an event to play some of these games when we could just play most of them at home now anyway, like, I'd get if it was something like E3 where the games aren't out yet, but or even PAX West, seeing that they're also, God, it feels
interested in attending. Can visit the official PAX West website for more details.
God, it's been ages since I've been to PAX. I miss PAX, man.
The top 10 players from each will get tickets. Please visit the official for more details. See you there.
A vast number of players are enjoying their time in Hyrule in The Legend of Zelda: Tears of the Kingdom.
which released last month. Thank you all very much. An amiibo figure of Link from the game was released to coincide with the game's launch.
Okay.
New amiibo of Zelda and Ganondorf are planned to be released this holiday.
Not surprised.
We're looking forward to them. Okay, this next segment will be our last announcement. Please take a look.
Okay. Is it going to be Zelda again for the fifth time at this point? No, it's a Mario announcement? Okay, it's a new 2D Mario adventure, I guess? This is looking like Super Mario Run, but... or maybe not. The vibe was kind of giving me that at first, but... this looks really trippy. Definitely looks weird anyway. Super Mario Bros. Wonder. I don't mind, like, the chibier designs for some of these characters. Also, playable Daisy, that, I think, is new. Oh, can we just have, like, an entire crew of playable Yoshis there? I might have just been relegated to, like, a sub-area, but... Super Mario Bros. Wonder. October 2023. Hmm.
Whoa, Zoe! That Goomba looks so sore. Well then.
That was the brand new 2D side-scrolling Mario game, Super Mario Brothers Wonder.
Okay.
When you touch a Wonder Flower, expect the unexpected. The ground could start moving, or you might turn...
Kind of reminds me a little bit of Crash Bandicoot 4, just with all the kind of weird, like, some of the weird filters that they kind of had at one point.
We'll share more details in the future, so we hope you'll look forward to it.
That's all for today's Nintendo Direct.
Okay.
Thank you for watching.
Alright. This Direct was alright. You know, for me, the Pikmin news and Super Mario RPG remake were definitely the two biggest highlights for me. The rest, I'm trying to think if anything really, like, stood out to me that much beyond that. Persona 5 Tactica as well, well, we already knew about that, though. No word on Persona 3 Remake on Switch, apparently, which I thought was, like, kind of half leaked at one point, but I don't really know for sure anyway. Detective Pikachu, I mean, I've never, like, played the first one, so I can't really vouch for that. I can't really vouch for the Princess Peach game either. We haven't seen enough to really know too much about it. Arkham Trilogy is not really new, but it's still nice to have that on the Switch, especially when Arkham City was like a Wii U launch title, I'm pretty sure, so nice to see that at least on the Switch. The rest of this was kind of just sort of okay. Dragon Quest Monsters look kind of neat, but yeah. Pikmin 4 looks pretty neat. In some ways, I would have to check the pre-order pages and see if, like, Pikmin 1 and 2 can, like, be bought together or something. I'll still probably get them, but yeah. Metal Gear Solid looks pretty neat. I'm kind of interested in Petey Piranha coming back, but I don't really have a whole lot of other thoughts on this. I didn't actually catch the date on this. Oh, never mind, there is no release date. That also helps as well. Star Ocean actually looked kind of neat. WarioWare looked, I don't know, again, besides the 64 DS references, it's a little strange, but yeah. Not the worst Direct in the world, though. Mario RPG Remake looks great. I'm definitely, out of everything in this, this is probably the one that caught my eye the most. This looks like, yeah. And Geno will still never be mainly playable in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Get wrecked, scrub.